Hey everyone, today's tutorial is all about this sticky split layout. So what we can see is if I start to scroll down the page here, what we'll get is the left-hand side sticking. And it basically gives our users a lot of context about what is going on right now. They can see that this sidebar is kind of to do with this. The content doesn't get lost. Go down, it disconnects, and we go on the next one, and it looks, again, really great. It gives our users a lot more context about what's going on. Now, this was actually inspired by Useful Books, a site that I really love. And you can see here, as I scroll down, it gives our users a lot of context about what's happening on the right-hand side. Basically, as we get to the next section, what happens is it disconnects when we get to the bottom, and then the next section appears. And then it sticks in the same way. Now, when I was thinking about this, it's actually something that I've actually built before. It was something we did as part of SuperHi Plus website. And as you can see here, if I start scrolling down the page, this next section sticks. It gives people a lot more context about what is going on the right-hand side. So in today's video, we're going to talk about how this site over here was made and using this sticky split layout. So firstly, we're going to start off with a fairly basic version of the site, something that looks like this. When I scroll down the page, our users do lose context. So notice when we get to this point, when we start to scroll, that basically the information disappears and we don't really have any context about what is happening here. And again, this kind of area over here is pretty empty space. So it'd be good to kind of keep it sticky. Now, let's quickly talk about how this site was made. So if we look at our HTML, it's fairly kind of basic, actually. We've got a section here, which is basically a grid layout. We have a div class title and then a div class info, basically the split layout. Next section is doing the same thing. We've got another section here with a split layout with a title and info. And then there's basically the kind of information that you expect. And that's basically it. Now, you might think we need some complex JavaScript to do this, but we don't. It's actually fairly built into CSS now. So what do we need to do? Well, let's have a look at our style sheet. Now at the top here, I've got my typography, I've got my colors, I've got a reset in here, I've got some styling with the fonts and all kind of the usual stuff. And then when we get to the section itself, we've got this display grid. And this is basically a two column grid. It's a one fraction and one fraction, which is 50-50. And what we have at the moment is the idea, and when we have the section is, basically, this kind of fills this whole area. Notice this purple area goes all the way down to the bottom. But what I want to do is basically make this area on this side kind of fill a certain area of space instead. So to do this, what we're going to say is, let's make this grid system not go all the way to the bottom. Let's say instead, let's align the items just to the start. Don't make them stretch to the bottom. So just to the start. Now, what this will give us is something that looks like this. Basically, it kind of reduces to fill its space, which kind of looks a little bit weird and doesn't really give us, again, what we want. So the next thing we want to do is just basically make this the height of the page itself, this kind of left-hand side. Now, to do this, I've got this section with div.title. Here, I'm just going to give it a height. Height here is going to be 100 VH, the viewport height. Viewport is what we can see, so it's just the height. Now, what we can see now is this does fill this, but only to kind of the height of the browser. And then we can see the rest of it in here. But what I want to do is keep this area following down this kind of area until I hit the next bit. To do this is actually fairly straightforward. What we're going to add in here is basically something called position sticky. And what we want to do is say, where is well, I want this to be sticky to the browser, to the top of the browser, where? Top zero. Just by adding this in, what we'll get very, very quickly is this sticks, and it looks really, really good. And basically what's happening is this 100% area is filling the entire bit of the page, but then when we hit the bottom here, it disconnects. It basically says, this is the bottom of the section, I'm kind of done, I can't go any further. So it's kind of fun as up and down the page. Now, what I did is I removed the background from here because now what we can do is just quickly add that in. I actually uncommented it earlier. So we can just uncomment this. And even when we have this kind of area here, this is 100% height and now it's fallen us down the page. And then when we hit the bottom, it lets go. So by just adding these very short amounts of code in here, basically what we've done is said, fill the entire space, be position sticky and top zero. It kind of looks really good. Now you might be wondering, What happens if we're on mobile? Let's make it a lot smaller. And what we'll see here is we've added a bit of code in here. So what I've done is just said this position static. Static just means the default. And then we've got height of auto in here as well. So then when we're on mobile, we're letting go as well. So by adding these very small amounts of bits of code in here, we've just made this sticky split layout very, very quickly. So that was a quick one. If you like this video, please give it a like. If you haven't subscribed already, please do so. It helps the channel. And if there's anything you'd like me to cover in the future, please add it in the comments below. And there should be two videos here for you to watch.